Hello to everyone. My name is Oscar Palomares and I am professor at Complutense University of Madrid. It is my great pleasure to share with you today our last findings published in Allergy. The cannabinoid WIN552122 suppresses effector T cell responses and promotes regulatory T cells in human tonsils. The endocannabinoid system is a very complex signaling network involved in many physiological processes, and their alterations have been related to many different diseases, including immunomediated disorders. The main components of the endocannabinoid system include the endocannabinoid ligands, such as, for example, anandamide or 2-AG, the enzymes related to their synthesis and degradation, and also the cannabinoid receptors, the canonical CB1 and CB2, but also other non-canonical cannabinoid receptors. WIN552122, I will call it from here onwards just as WIN, is a synthetic cannabinoid agonist for CB1 and CB2 that shows anti-inflammatory properties. We previously saw it that WIN restores rhinovirus-induced epithelial barrier dysfunction, and more recently we have demonstrated that cannabinoids in general, but WIN in particular, is able to promote tolerogenic dendritic cells able to generate FOXP3 positive regulatory T cells in peripheral dendritic cells by mechanisms involving autophagy and metabolic reprogramming. So considering all these aspects in this study, we sought to investigate whether tonsil dendritic cells express functional cannabinoid receptors and also whether WIN could immunomodulate T cell responses in human tonsils. So tonsils are the single easily accessible lymphoid organs in the body, and we previously shown that tonsils are organs of immunotolerance where the generation of regulatory T cells take place by mechanisms partially depending on plasmacytoid dendritic cells. So here we isolated tonsil tissues, and from these tissues, we purified tonsil plasmacytoid dendritic cells and also type 2 conventional dendritic cells following conventional protocols to assess gene expression profile by quantitative PCR. So here you can clearly see that both tonsil PDCs and type 2 conventional dendritic cells express all the components of the endocannabinoid system at the mRNA level. Interestingly, plasmacytoid dendritic cells and also type 2 conventional dendritic cells express functional cannabinoid receptors. As you can see here, WIN is able to suppress the production of pro-inflammatory cytokines induced by specific toll like receptor ligands, both in PDCs, but also on type 2 conventional dendritic cells. So next, we wanted to study the expression of these receptors at the protein level in the tonsil tissues. And for that, we perform immunohistochemistry experiments followed by confocal microscopy technology. So here, you can clearly see that both plasmacytoid dendritic cells, but also conventional type 2 conventional dendritic cells express CB1 here in green, in the T-cell areas of human tonsils. In contrast, type 2 conventional dendritic cells, but not plasmacytoid dendritic cells, express at CB2, you can see here, and not here in the PDCs, at the protein level in the T-cell areas of human tonsils. So next, we wanted to study the capacity of WIN to modulate or immunomodulate T cell responses in the human tonsils. For that, we isolated tonsil mononuclear cells from the tissues and stimulated these TMCs with a mixture of anti-CD2, CD3, and CD28 antibodies to induce T cell proliferation and activation with or without WIN. We measured T cell proliferation, cytokine production, and the generation of FOXP3 positive regulatory T cells. As you see here, WIN significantly impair the induction of T cell proliferation motivated or induced by the mixture of monoclonal antibodies, as well as inhibited the production of Th1, Th2, IL-5 and IL-13, and TH17 cytokines induced by the activation with this combination of monoclonal antibodies in the tonsil tissues. Interestingly, Gwynne significantly enhanced the percentage of FOXP3 positive regulatory T cells under the assayed conditions, thus demonstrating that Gwynne is able to suppress effector T cell responses while promoting regulatory T cells in human tonsils. So in conclusion, we have demonstrated that both tonsil purified plasmacytoid dendritic cells and also type 2 conventional dendritic cells express functional cannabinoid receptors. And very importantly, Gwynne is able to suppress effector T cell responses and to promote regulatory T cells in the human tonsils. Altogether, this data might well pave the way for the future development of novel cannabinoid-based vaccines targeting dendritic cells in human tonsils. And that is all I wanted to tell you today. Thank you very much for your attention.